by Klingberg there. Just a quick transition that almost created that chance.
Here's Lucas Reichel to Johnson. Korchinski, the shot turned aside by Wohl. Here's a loose puck in front of the net to the club stop. And Wohl's going to flip back in after a save on Taylor Radish.
Get yourself into that regular season game action. And look at the patience there, not overreacting.
There's Noah Gregor trying to feed the point. And it's Taylor Hall, pump, but he heads in along with Bedard and drops it off. Donato, stopped by Wohl. And a rebound. Here's Hall. Back to the line, Jones, and Donato unable to tip that. It cycles it around to the near side. Giordano moves up to punch it for Tavares in front, Nylander. Nice stop by Soderblom.
Get back there. Here's good pinch in by Giordano. Now Tavares knows exactly where Nylander was, but there's a nice save by Soderblom, just keeping his good position. Got the blocker on it. And
now Bedard trying to pull away. Nice burst. Connor Bedard in. Forehand and a big stop by Wohl. A rebound in front. And it missed Hall. What a dangerous dash for 98. That deflected wide by Hall. Taylor Hall's on it again, back to Bedard. At the line, Zaitsev can't get it to the net.
You know, covering the space, he's got his head up the entire way, puts the puck to an area and uses his feet to get him to the outside. I like the fact that he didn't just go to the outside, he took it hard to the net there and he tried just the quick backhand forehand.
Although Corey Perry is.
Yeah, he's having a chat with Reeves right now as he yells from the bench.
No, Luke Richardson was talking about how much Corey Perry talks to the referees. And
oh, here we go.
Gregor is going to go with Connor Murphy. So a response to the hit, whether they saw it the way we did or not.
Talking with Reeves, it was on the back end, and there had to have been a discussion before because it wasn't even a hesitation. You know that what will happen on the ice is guys will come and say, Gregor, you're going to have to deal with the hit that you made, and it's Murphy who drew.
Fight. The last time Noah Gregor was in a fight was against Connor Murphy last season.
Now, if you saw those stats there, Perry's got more penalty minutes than Reeves does, 1,300 to just under 1,100, so maybe that was the discussion, who's got more.
So we start the second period. They adjusted the shots 10-6 in favor of Chicago in that opening period as Marner deflects it inside the line, gets it back again. No shots for Austin Matthews in that first period. McCabe played 130 games as a member of the Blackhawks. Seth Jones up ahead. Now Kachuk over the line, and whistle, Kachuk, Athanasiou, shot by Wohl. Now a centering pass, and scores, McKenzie, and whistle opens the scoring as the Leafs give up the first goal for the third consecutive game.
The line, as I said, Entwistle comes in, gets his first opportunity of the year. Does a good job coming through the middle of the ice. One good save by Joseph Wohl there, but a chance to clear the puck and a little miscue defensively. Both Klingberg and McCabe missed their assignment here, a missed stick by both of them, and Entwistle gets that one off the post and in.
One more game on the extended road trip to start. Great move. Nylander's in to the middle. Drops. Tavares scores. It's a beauty for John Tavares on the Nylander setup.
Right through training camp, through the exhibition games. It's just a great move at the line that turns Murphy around. Now a little drop pass.
Now Bedard drops it back for Seth Jones. And Hall. Rick wide, here's Bedard, boom, stop, Joseph Wohl.
Here, Seth Jones shot now, just a little hesitation, he had to.
That deflect high in the air, play back, and Kachuk there for Chicago. Leaned on by Brody, Foligno off the bench, back to the line, Korchinski with a shot to the net. And now it's been a hit by Liljegren. Corey Perry steps onto the ice, puck arrives. And now Vlasic for Foligno. Back to Perry. Walking in. Fought off rebound. In front. Matthews has stepped on. Here's Morgan Riley. Another dangerous burst by William Nylander in behind the net. Nylander tied up there with Jones. And it's sent away. Breakaway. Corey Perry scores. Oh, the old Leaf killer has struck again. And it's 2-1 Blackhawks.
Wow, he had a sequence of just end-to-end action. But a heads-up play here by Vlasic. Tape to tape and the quick wrister. The calm point to the crowd. Look at Perry just sees. He got a change by the Maple Leafs. He gets lost in the distance. And what a great outlet pass by the young defenseman Vlasic. And then the quick release underneath the blocker.
Giordano on the scene. And the backhand swipe by Yarko. Kept in by Jones. In front Donato. Now Hall. Taylor Hall in behind the net. Shot off the post. He'll try and limit that. Bring it down. Here comes Tyler Johnson. Athanasiou over the line. Johnson with the D and scores. Tyler Johnson, first power play goal for Chicago on the season. And the Blackhawks have a two-goal lead.
You've got a guy who's won the Stanley Cup and Johnson who's off to just a fantastic start as he just drives right through the middle and shows great calmness and patience. Athanasiou to his backhand in the pass and Joseph Woll thought he was going to go high there and just a quick little release underneath the glove. That's a tough move for a goaltender to react to.
Third period, Connor Bedard 3-6 in the faceoff circle and each of those draws against Auston Matthews, who wins possession for Toronto to start the third. Trying to pin him along the boards. Bertuzzi up with it. Back to Brody. Brody shot the slot and off the crossbar. Matthews with the deflection on the shot pass by Brody.
A great play by Bertuzzi to keep that puck alive along the boards, though, and make the play back to the point to even make that play possible.
Back in Bertuzzi. Now Nylander checks in. Bertuzzi continues the battle. Here's a chance, and Soderblom makes the stop. Watched by the veteran Foligno. Back to Riley and across. Klingberg, Riley, and Nylander down low in front. Great stop by Soderblom, and how did that stay out?
As far as he can, you're outnumbered down right by the net as three Leafs against two, and just a little shuttle pass, and the rebound was right there. Soderblom gets his pad right up against the post. As the first tip, he makes a good save. It's the second one that he's...
If the score ends like this, Perry would have his first ever game-winning goal against Toronto, which just seems hard to believe. There's an empty net goal for Taylor Hall, and it's 4-1 Chicago.
The outside to get that one in. Taylor Hall back after missing the last game with a shoulder, and he puts an end to this. So Taylor Hall looking now, going, the fact that they're looking at it is something in its own right. Tight it's going to be. Let's have a look with the bouncing puck. Did he have control? Oh, no. Yeah. I don't think he ever really had control, right? This one is going to come back. You know, we've seen so many different cases of controlling the puck.
After review, the play was deemed to be offside and before no roll on the play.
Tavares waves, so Matthews to take this faceoff. Back to Nylander. His shot hit a leg. Radish is going to send it the length of the ice into the net. And now it is 4-1 Chicago.
Off the draw, everybody's focused. The Leafs get the win, but it just says Riley's coming through. Nylander's trying to get it to the front of the net for a rebound. Can we finally end this thing?
I think so. That was 6 seconds to go, and the clock will drain. The Blackhawks are 2-2.